After a decade of waiting, finally we got J Electronica's debut album, A Written Testimony. Back in 2008, J Electronica was one of the most talked about rappers in that year. They were wondering when he's gonna release an album because of the singles that he released were so rich, the samples are so good, the beats were so different, really experimental, and it had this old school boom bap hip hop style. So yeah, ever since that year, everybody has been anticipating for an album, we're gonna get something. But in 2017, he dropped another song. But still, people were asking themselves, when are we gonna get a J Electronica album? He did have an idea, but then scrapped it, and we never got to see that album. But then this year, 2020, back in February, he was saying that the album was near and that it was finally done, and that it took him 40 nights and 40 days to complete. Which was pretty interesting, from scrapping a whole concept of a previous album to this album, just recording it in 40 days. That's actually pretty mind-blowing. So then yesterday, J Electronica delivered the album. And I gotta say, for a debut album, it's actually pretty good. So in the first track, The Overwhelming Event, we get to hear this beautiful set of strings that are playing, and we get to hear this sample of this man saying that the black people are actually the real children of Israel. In the next track, Ghost of Soulja Slim, we get to hear JC rapping over this beat, in which he says that he's the ghost of Soulja Slim, and that he's going to take other souls and not let people take his soul. It's almost like if he was like a samurai or like a grim reaper sort of, but like a gangster at the same time. J Electronica raps in this track about people that are trying to bring him down, or problems that are trying to bring him down, and also being grateful for being in Roc Nation, as Roc Nation kind of helped him. It's kind of like his new family in this track. In this album, JC's heavily involved here. There's like 8 tracks where he's in. I don't really mind that, but I just wish that J Electronica had more time here. He had more verses here. But even though that is one of my major critiques of the album, I still like the chemistry of JC and J Electronica carry in this album. It's like there's 2 different point of view. At the same time, they're comparing their problems to like stories from the Bible. And I also like the references and metaphors that uses J Electronica comparing the religion to his life and his problems in these tracks. In the third track, The Blinding, we get to hear this hard 808 beat, which is kind of weird for J Electronica rapping, because we're mostly used for him to rapping old school boom bap beats that are a bit experimental. But at this time, we get production from Hit Boy, who has produced like Kendrick Lamar, Big Sean, and so on. But we get to hear in the first part Swizz Beatz talking, and then we get to hear the verse from J Electronica, and he talks more about this track, referring to himself, referring to talking about his struggles, talking about the problems, like the blinding, like the problems that are kind of blinding his sight. We also get to get a pretty decent verse from JC. Travis Scott is involved with this track. 3 lines here, and he delivers the chorus. I think the chorus is kind of weak in this track, not gonna lie. I feel like he didn't necessarily need to be here. I think his verse was odd, to be honest. But overall, the track is pretty good. In The Neverending Story, we get to hear J Electronica reference some religious references in here, talking about his come up, how he relates with these religious references, how he kind of like uses the adjectives and how he uses these words, these similes and these metaphors combined together to kind of form how the story of his come up was. And also JC talking about his current state, how he's a goat, that people say that he's defects on him, but he's not, and that he's perfect and he's kind of like the goat. I also like this track because of how smooth this track is, the guitars that are playing, the slow samples that are playing in the background. J Electronica also feels that his life is like a never-ending story. It just never ends, and more problems keep occurring in his life over and over and over. In The Shiny Suit Theory, possibly my favorite track from this album, J raps about people telling him to be better than other people, how he should have a GOAT status, be better than others, stop being underground, stop being less known, and just get that GOAT status, get that Grammy, get that cash, basically be a legend. And I also like JC's point of view, but it's kind of like talking to a psychiatrist here, and then when he's trying to say that he's trying to receive GOAT status, the psychiatrist kind of stops him and says that you'll never achieve that, that black people cannot achieve the type of status, that it's almost impossible for them, that he's kind of delusional. I also like the beat that plays here. I love that sample that plays. It is it is really good. The producers here, the production is great. I love the samples they have there. The choice is pretty smooth. The production is great as always. And I also like the Dreams verse in here. I think the chorus is pretty nice. And I also like the effects, the filter, and Universal Soldier, which I really wasn't crazy about this. I feel like James Blake's verse in here with the effects and all, I think it was kind of useless. He raps about being a Universal Soldier, or soldier that has seen everything around this world, and he's fought everything that has come in his way. Jay-Z delivers an okay verse here. I wasn't necessarily a big fan of this track. I wasn't really crazy about it. And Flux Capacitor, the chorus was a little bit weak, not gonna lie. I didn't like the chorus that much. But overall, I think Jay-Z's verse and Jay Electronica's verse is actually pretty good. I like how Jay-Z is kind of saying that he's Moses, that he's kind of like built Roc Nation, which is kind of like him comparing Christianity, like how Roc Nation have helped other people, like it was Christianity, like religion that has helped other people become better selves, kind of like giving aspiring rappers more chances. And at Jay Electronica's point of view, he's talking like Roc Nation was like the Christianity for him, like it was a religion that has helped him in his past, like it was kind of like his new family, and it came with open arms with him, and how he's really grateful for being a Roc Nation. Because in the title it says Fruits of the Spirit, but mostly here I think the fruits are like bad fruits or something, because he talks about the bad things, the problems that are happening in his life and also in the world as well. It's a pretty short track at 1 minute and 44 seconds of length, but it's actually really good. I like the little freestyle that he lays here. I like the references as well, the similes and metaphors that he lays here about Christianity and the Arabian religion here, how he's comparing himself to his come up as well, and also how he's comparing his problems to other problems that there were in the stories in the Bible. And Eskil's Wheel, if I'm saying that correctly, Jay raps about him surviving his problems finally, and also talking about how from a rookie he's established to become a legend, how a lot of people have been liking him, how from nothing he's became kind of like a god, sort of, I guess you could say. I didn't like this track that much. I think it was a little bit too long, because the instrumental isn't bad. I think it's pretty good, but I feel like it stretched out a little bit too much in the end. I think Jay's verse isn't necessarily that great. I didn't like it that much. I think it was okay. And also saying, and also the references that he has here from becoming a rookie to a legend, and also that Star Wars bar comparing from him from a rookie to a legend, how he's moved different planets, actually a pretty good bar explaining his come up. But yeah, overall I feel like the instrumental is kind of dreamy, kind of slow. The drums are smooth and slow, but I think this track was a little too long, to be honest. I think even though Jay Electronica's verse is great, I still think there are some things that were lacking here. I feel like it could have been shorter, it could have been better. In the final track, APIDTA, if I'm spelling that correctly, it's actually one of the most emotional tracks in this album. Jay Electronica talking about his mother's passing, how unfortunate it was, and also him talking about how painful it was for him to handle after his mother's death. The drugs wasn't helping him overcome his anxiety at all after his mother's death, and how he was scrolling in her text messages and seeing that she was dealing with her problems herself, and that also was her loss of her mother. And it's ironic because he's dealing with the same thing that her mother was dealing with. And also Jay-Z lays a pretty good verse in here, even though it can be a little bit spaced out too much. I still think that Jay-Z's verse is great. Is like connecting with Jay Electronica. I like how he's also talking about the past of his loved ones, how his loved ones died, how he's not gonna get those people to call him back, to text him back, how it feels for him, how hard it is for him as well. I also like the emotion of both of their voices. Jay-Z sounds kind of paranoid, as well as Jay Electronica. Feel his emotions like a lot here, like he's super, super sad. But yeah, overall, A Written Testimony, I love this album. It's actually pretty great. My biggest critiques for this album, as I was saying, I wish we could have heard more of Jay Electronica here, probably more verses in here instead of Jay-Z, because I think Jay-Z, even though he does have some solid verses, I still think Jay Electronica should have been more. He has some pretty interesting wordplay here. I think he's pretty creative as an artist. His wordplay, as I was saying, was fantastic. I like the symbols and metaphors that he has. Something has some funny lines, as I feel like me Nyon Bar, so I'll turn you into beef in one track. But yeah, overall, I liked his wordplay. I liked his punchlines. They were so good. His lyrics. Jay Electronica in this album proves to be a pretty versatile lyricist, and I wish you guys to hear more music of him ASAP, because this guy is pretty pretty good for a rapper and a lyricist as well. The album is great, the production is fantastic, top notch. It is top notch, and I also understand why the title is called A Written Testimony, because it feels like if he's giving a testimony with his life, like his life and his problems, comparing to religion, comparing to the Bible, comparing to the stories from the Bibles with his life and how it feels like a written testimony. Like this whole album feels like it was like a testimony of his life. I really like that reference that he's making there. A great album, definitely solid. So yeah, what would I give A Written Testimony? 8 out of 10, solid production, as I was saying, solid verses. This proves that J Electronica has more in the future as a lyricist, as a versatile rapper. So yeah, what do you guys think about this album? Leave it in the comments down below. Leave a like, subscribe, turn notifications on, and peace out, everybody.